A generation ago, the future for children with single ventricle defects was uncharted territory. Today, doctors can give families a roadmap of what to expect from before birth to adulthood. It doesn't mean everything will go smoothly, but it does mean the medical team and the family are better informed and better prepared to deal with whatever comes along.
There was a period of time in the 1970s and 1980s where, in fact, there was no hope whatsoever for these children, with the vast majority not surviving beyond perhaps even the first few days of life.
In the early part of our experience with single ventricle heart defects, survival was our main goal.
Today, our focus is a different one. It's to not just create survival, which in essence is expected in the vast majority of cases, but to create a sustainable quality of life and to create a normal duration of life.
There's more focus on trying to prevent problems and trying to anticipate them.
To be able to give families a roadmap so that they can have at least an idea of what to expect over time.
Overall, our expectation is that these kids will not only survive, but survive with a good quality of life.
Part of the ability to better treat single ventricle defects is simply knowing about them earlier. Jason's condition was not discovered until after he was born and had gone home from the hospital.
And when the visiting nurse came, she said, "You need to call 911 right away." And that's when I panicked. So the ambulance came, they took Jason, and you feel, I just felt so sad, and I felt so overwhelmed, like, and so helpless. Like, here is my firstborn, my beautiful baby boy. We got him out of the hospital, and now they're telling me that he's having these major heart problems.
Before fetal ultrasound was something that was fairly routine, it was not uncommon at all for babies to come in deathly ill, very acidotic, very poor blood flow to their body, with damage to their kidneys, damage to their liver, damage to their brains very often, damage to their lungs and all their organs, because we did not know that they had this problem and it was unanticipated. And when one starts with that as the starting point for trying to go into a very complex series of operations, it's not surprising that the outcomes are not nearly as good.
I think it was 10 days before they were able to operate on him. So to stabilize him for these 10 days, to make sure that no major organ damage have occurred to him, all this could have been avoided had we known ahead of time.